I hope this doesn't sound awful, but I really need someone better than that. I'm afraid I'll have to spend the rest of my life here for the sake of an accident.
You must have friends who could contact a solicitor for you.
You lose a lot of friends when you're the mistress of a married man. See, I just live to spend every moment with Robin. I can hardly go to his friends now.
All right, leave it with me. I'll see what I can do.
Thank you.
Heard anything yet?
About what?
Punishment. You remember that far back?
No, they'll probably let us off with a warning.
Oh, you reckon?
Well, I'm not worried.
Well, I bloody well am.
Yeah, but you're a natural worrier. Just like our friend Merv.
What's he got to do with a price of eggs?
Well, I was just thinking about that little arrangement you had with him. What'd you have on the little word?
He'd try and give you one.
Oh, come off it, Lou.
Look, it'd be much easier for everybody if you just told me.
Get stuffed! You try anything with me and you'll be sorry. And you're wrong about Nora too. She's got something real nasty planned, I can tell.
I ain't scared of that bitch. She's going soft. Reckon you are too.
You're so far up yourself, it's a miracle you can walk. If I cop it bad for this, I'm going to get you for it. You can be sure of that.
I'm real sorry. They frightened me.
They're just doing their job.
Doesn't make it any easier, but...
You just have to show them how strong you are.
I'm as thick as two short planks. Everybody knows that.
That's not true, and I won't have you believing it either.
Very sorry to keep you waiting. Come through. We're going to do some other tests now, a different kind. You write these. Sit down, please. Make yourself comfortable. Now, here's one that's been done to give you the idea. You tick the ones with the right answers.
You just want to show I'm stupid, don't you? You're the one that's making me muck up these tests.
You want to tell us why you think that?
No, I don't. I just want to go. Just let
don't
me
mess
go.
Up now. Not now.
No, I just want to go.
I want to talk before we go any further.
We've still got a lot to do, and I haven't got
can't
time to...
Can't you see you brought this on?
I realise you're very involved with your client,
after you two have put her through the mince, it'll be a wonder if she doesn't need psychiatric care.
Hang on, this isn't getting anywhere. No, this is not your field, Mr. Fulbright. I'm sorry, but you will have to accept our judgment.
It doesn't take 10 years of training to realise you pushed her over the edge.
You don't understand the situation. We're assessing her. How she stands up under this sort of pressure is part of what we're looking at.
Well, look at her now. You're responsible for that. Admit it.
Oh, I've had enough of your interference. I want you to leave.
Well, you'll just have to get used to my interference, won't you? You're deliberately working against her case. If she's mentally unbalanced now, it's because you've made her that way.
Not true!
And I'll make sure the courts disregard any evidence you put before them.
She doesn't know any other solicitors. I'm going to talk to Ben about it.
Yes, well, it is a little unusual.
I know. But I believe her story. It doesn't sound like the sort of thing you'd make up.
Well, you've read the statements. The missing bullet.
Don't worry, I'm not going to say it publicly, but I feel she's innocent. I have to give her every chance.
Yes, oh, well, I feel the same way.
I'm a bit worried about how the women are going to react to her. She's very, well, glamorous is the word.
Yes, well, there could be trouble.
Yes, well, she's going to have to meet them all eventually.
Say, we got the right place.
All right, you lot, this is Eve Wilder. Show her the ropes.
Well, come and meet everyone.
Please don't turn it off on my account.
Oh, it was nothing. I'm Nora Flynn. This is Julie Egbert, May Collins, Jenny Harkley.
Hi.
I'm Willie Beecham.
Oh, I'm pleased to meet you all. I just hope I can remember all of your names.
You'll get used to it soon enough, love.
I wanted to stay in my cell, but they insisted I come down here.
Oh, well, come in. You're very welcome to share our humble little place.
Thank you. Thank you. From what Miss Ferguson said, I expected it all be unfriendly.
Oh, la la. What this little number cost you, eh?
Sorry, I don't remember.
She doesn't remember.
That because Sanderson bought it for you?
Cut it out, Kelly. Give her a go.
Just ignore her, dear. Though I must say I recognise quality when I see it.
The colours suit you.
I hear blood red suits her best. You're in enough trouble, Kelly. Now shut up.
Please don't start a row over me. I understand how you feel. How could you help it? I did shoot Robin, but I didn't mean to. I just want to be friends with you all. I'm sorry.
Well, either you are innocent, love, or your mother should have put you on the stage.
Yeah, well, I mean, you know, when you're loaded, you've got to be good at acting, and when it's your meal ticket that's loaded, you've got to be good at keeping it up all day.
for her.
You'd hang her before you even talk to her. Well, she didn't mean to do it. You can see by looking at her face. You're doing exactly what you did to me.
Oh, yeah, I'm sorry. The woman's innocent. I mean, she says so herself.
You poison everything. You've got so you don't know when someone's telling the truth anymore.
Miss Wilder sounds like some woman. Should get myself an introduction.
Better be careful. She loves them and shoots them.
Small price to pay.
I don't think she makes a habit of it.
No, that's the inside story anyway. The papers seem to be pretty cagey about it.
Police aren't saying anything till they find the bullet.
A few holes in her story, eh?
Ben!
Sorry. They convinced it's murder?
She admits she shot him, but insists it was an accident.
Why wouldn't you?
I know it's ridiculous to get involved, but I can't help thinking she's innocent.
Occupational hazard.
Not usually. I mean, you develop a gut instinct about these things, but I have been proved wrong before.
It'll make for an interesting defence anyway.
That's another thing. A lawyer had to drop the case, ill health apparently. She asked me to find someone to take over.
Oh, here we go again.
What do you think?
Well, it's tempting.
But?
Oh, I've really got my hands full with Daphne's case at the moment. I'm determined to win anyway after all that ridiculous nonsense at the hospital today.
Well, Ben, don't tell me you're turning down work. Watch out, you might end up with some free time.
I think I do know someone who would be prepared to take it. An old friend of mine, ahead of me at law school.
Would he be interested?
Could be. Just got back from overseas.
Might need a break before he starts.
I doubt it. Could kill two birds with one stone here. Needs to get out of himself. He's just had a very messy breakup with his wife. Well, people will get themselves into these things.
Be great if he'd do it.
His name's Adams, David Adams. I'll call him tomorrow.
Can I come in?
If you want to.
I'd like to talk if you feel up to it.
I didn't think it mattered what anyone thought around here.
That's what I thought at first. Don't take it too badly, what some of them said in there.
It's not important.
Of course it's important.
No, it's not. Not after what's happened.
Oh, you can't let the women get to you like that. Just give them a little time. They'll come round. They're not too bad. Some of them are really lovely people. Unfortunately, there are some like Killy who make it hard on everyone.
It's not them. I don't care anymore. My life's over.
Don't say that.
It's true. I have no life without Robin.
Look, what I've come to say is, when I first came here, I made a real botch of coping with it all. I don't want you to make the same mistake. And you can't go on moping for the rest of your life.
That's all right for you.
Everyone in here's got something they've got to live with. Guilt or fear. Even the ones who are here by mistake.
Oh, I don't think I'm the sort of person who can survive in this place.
I didn't think I could either. It's amazing what you can do when you have to.
Oh, what's the point? I shot him. It's my fault and I deserve what he was coming to me.
Rubbish.
What would you know?
That's what I thought. I thought it was my fault my grandmother was murdered. Well, I'm innocent, but I started to believe that it was my fault it happened to her. If I'd gone to help her, I could have stopped it. But I didn't. That made me guilty too.
You didn't actually pull the trigger like I did.
You have to get over that. It's not my fault my grandmother's dead, and it's not your fault that Robin died.
Oh, there's no future in this place.
So what are you going to do? Just going to let yourself rot?
It's not up to me.
Oh, but it is up to you. That's what you've got to realise. Oh, and it's very important that you come back to the rec room with me now. Please?